Hi guys, Christina here. Welcome to my channel, Magic Travels. And as you see, I am in a van. It is empty right now, but my family is about to hop in and we are taking a family road trip to Tennessee. I'm super excited. It's like 5 o'clock in the morning. We have a long drive ahead of us. I've never been to Tennessee before. And I figured I'd vlog a little bit along the way. Miles left of Florida, almost. Woo! 5 hours into the trip, we just made it out of Florida. I am now at the Georgia Welcome Center. It's been an uneventful 5 hours of just napping and trees and road, but making really, really, really good time. And I hope that they have maps because I like to get maps in the state so I can keep track of where I'm going. I like watching like my progress along the roadway. It's much easier coming from north to south because the mile markers actually count down, so you can kind of tell how much longer you have in that state. But when you're driving north, you can't really tell, so that's where the handy dandy map comes in. We're literally getting pulled over right now. I don't even feel like we were going that fast, but we're getting pulled over. Just a warning though, not too bad, not too bad. We'll be on our way in a moment as soon as he brings the... That was quick and easy with some very nice service from the people at the desk. And I've got my map. Time to get back on the road. Is it even a road trip if you don't stop at Waffle House? I am still in South Carolina. I took over driving for a bit. And of course, like, it was sunny and beautiful and the traffic was wonderful all day, but as soon as I took over driving, it started raining and traffic wasn't cooperative and there were a ton of potholes in the road. But I'm getting a break now. I'm gonna go to the bathroom, get back on the road. I should also mention that when I left Florida this morning, it was beautiful out. You know, it was 5 o'clock in the morning, but it was about 72, 73. It is now about 56 degrees and windy. But it feels great. I'm looking forward to some crisp, cool weather in Tennessee. Yay! And I'm back at the van, full of sleeping cousins.
Like they've got some maps right here.
here. Oh, it's been such a long day. It is 50 degrees out and I'm really cold, but my jacket's buried in the trunk and we still have an hour until we get to the cabin. Trip to Tennessee. I drove here yesterday. It was a really long drive. Knocked out real hard last night. And starting off today, I am at Flapjack's Pancake Cabin. I'm so excited. Let's go inside.
I enjoyed my food very, very much.
So I think it's safe to say that Flapjack's was a hit. Like, my entire family just loves
it. This cute little section. Look at these little Flapjack Pancake Cabin cups. Oh, those are cute. Got some little masks and toys for kids. Some princess stuff, some hats. But I really, really like this place. Like, it's delicious, legit. If they have a Flapjack Pancake Cabin ornament, I might buy it. They got some jewelry and some bracelets. Look at these little avocados. You walk my world.
Oh my goodness, there's a Bigfoot collar.
That's so funny. Half of my family is like super into and scared of Bigfoot. So they're afraid of him by the cabins. I kind of want to buy this and call him just to scare them. Okay, I'm walking out now. My family's ahead of me because I was taking videos of stuff in the little store that they have inside. But that was delicious. If you ever come to Pigeon Forge, Gatlinburg area, I highly recommend stopping here. We all enjoyed our food. We inhaled it so fast, I barely got to take any pictures or videos. But I got the Spanish skillet with chorizo, and it was like spicy and yummy. They had bear pancakes for the kids. That was super, super cute. My sister-in-law got chicken and waffles that the whole family started picking out and enjoyed. So definitely recommend.
We talk about these mountains. Oh my goodness. I wonder if people who like live by mountains get really excited when they see mountains, or they're just don't even notice them after a while.
I get excited by flat land.
You get excited by flat lands?
Like,
I can't. Like, oh my goodness, that's probably true. Like, coming to Florida, they're like, that was so fast. I didn't have to go over any mountains or anything.
Yeah.
Wonder if they really like our roads. They probably don't find these roads scary. Like,
and
we
now
do.
We are at the Titanic Museum. You can see my cousins in the background. Valley. Kika's turned around. But yeah, we're gonna head inside.
This place is huge and amazing.
Boarding pass. Permission to come aboard. April 10th, 1912. Parts of noon. And then my name is Elizabeth Nye in this. This is so cool. Thank you. actually pretty cool. You're not allowed to take photo or video through like most of it because a lot of the artifacts are donated. So it's a like respect thing. So they don't want you taking photos or pictures of the artifacts for, you know, people who lost their family members. I can understand that. But it is really, really cool and beautiful. And they have like an audio tour. So I'm listening to the audio.
Wow, thing. Look at this violin.
$1.7 million is the highest price ever paid for this Titanic artifact. Wow. $1.7 million. That's insane. Ooh, I remember seeing this thing in the movie. They were like turning it for something. Okay, it doesn't move. Stop, slow, dead slow. I think this gave a signal to the workers below. Oh, and they're watertight panels. I'm steering the ship. Oh, this is harder to move than I thought. Iceberg, straight ahead. They were saying earlier in the tour that they only had 37 seconds to react to the iceberg. Like, that's insane. There was really nothing they could have done. Look at this iceberg.
Let's touch it.
It's cold. It's very cold. You can touch the 28 degree water. And oh, it is cold. Like, it is chilling. Let me see how long I can leave my hand in it. Honestly, it already really hurts. Like, it's stinging. And these people were in the water. The ones that survived the water were there for hours. I think the tour guide said it took them 3 hours, and I'm 24 seconds in and I'm feeling numb and okay, ow, ow, ow. It hurts. My hand really hurts. Of course, that exits to a gift shop, but look, they have like the little heart necklaces from the movie. That's cute.
All sorts of books in the gift shop.
They have maps, posters, they have DVDs,
candy.
I knew there'd be ornaments. All right, let me focus.
All right, I picked up my ornament.
I don't see anything else that I desperately want. Ooh, great, walking out. But that was so much fun. I got my ornaments. It was really cheap. It was only $6.50. Like, what a deal, let me tell you. But I really, really, really enjoyed that. I recommend if you're in the Pigeon Forge area, hit it up. We spent a few hours here, more than I expected. The staff was very knowledgeable and friendly. Apparently there are certain areas you can take pictures and videos and certain that you can't. So like I was taking video in one area after the piano guy said it was okay. I guess that did not apply to the rest of the area. But this was a lot of fun. Next stop, the island at Pigeon Forge. We are now at the island in Pigeon Forge. And we're going to explore a bit, shop a little bit, probably snack. I know they have vanilla mushrooms that I think we're gonna have dinner out later. Let's see what we can get into. The Ferris wheel looks awesome. I'm sure the views are amazing.
They have the shooting arcade.
Here are the passes that they offer. This rope course, I could never, I do not have it in me. But what looks really cool is at the end, they do like a little jump. They can jump down. If I could just do that, that sounds cool. But the rope course sounds way too strenuous.
So the Ferris wheel is actually closed right now for maintenance. They're hoping it'll be open by the end of the day.
Me too.
So there is the ticket center. They have an arcade, but the arcade is kind of pricey. There's a mirror maze over there. And some bumper cars, there's virtual reality, there's a laser maze. It all sounds pretty cool, but for a party of nine, it is insanely expensive to do like anything here.
Here's a peek inside the mirror maze. This looks horrifying, like I would be lost in here forever. Like every, I think I would just turn up, like turn around and hit mirrors over and over. And the lights going off. Oh no. can't cook fast because I'm super hungry and my phone's about to die. The crust is really good. It has like a perfect amount of crisp. So I've been at the island for a few hours. I went to some stores. The kids with us rode a bunch of the rides. The Ferris wheel, it's right above me right now, but it never turned on. Hopefully it'll be on tomorrow or the next day before I leave, because I really do want to see the view from up there. But the island's a pretty cool place. Mellow mushroom was really, really yummy. The crust was good, the cheese was good. Everything was really just quality ingredients. So overall, just, you know, awesome. I recommend it. If you're in the area, I recommend coming to the island for a few hours. Hang out by the water fountain features. It's so pretty. Get some lunch or dinner at Mellow Mushroom. And just have a really chill time.
It's really pretty here at night. I like all the lights. Oh, I can't wait to see the fountains all lit up.
Out of the island, they have the fountains going off behind me. It's so cool and pretty at night.